Once again, very good morning to you all. In our previous video, we show about the magnitude of unemployment in India. After this, let's see how unemployment is related with social, economic and political problems. Or in another way, we can say that how unemployment is a social, economic and political problem. Let's see these three topics in our today's video. Actually, unemployment is an economic, social and political problem which has troubled India since independence. Whenever we talk about economic problem, or we can say that underutilization or non-utilization of human resource, which involves heavy cost of maintenance and loss of production. Students, you know that India is an agricultural country and about 2/3 of our population is directly or indirectly engaged in agricultural activity for their livelihood. The agricultural operation in India suffers the problem of disgust unemployment. Even if the surplus labor is released from agriculture, they cannot be utilized gainfully in other industries because they are not skilled or trained. Increase in population is putting pressure on forest and environment. The need for fuel and fodder in rural areas is decreasing the area under forest cover. There is burden on economic infrastructure such as transport, communication, power, monetary and financial institution, which reduces the production and results in unemployment. Now let's see how unemployment is a social problem. As unemployment is a major social problem, as an unemployed person has to strive and struggle to get even bare minimum needs fulfilled. So, unemployed means underutilization of human resources, which results in loss of output and bring poverty to the nation. If the working population is given fuller and more productive employment, then the majority of the population will get sufficient income. It will help to raise the standard of living of the people and consequently the income, and also the removal of poverty in our country. Unemployment problem becomes more acute with the increase in population, and social problem crop up or rise up. we are not able to take due care for human life. Large number of elderly people live alone without any support from their children. Crime rate has become very high. During periods of unemployment, economic distress spills over to affect people's emotions and family lives. Thus, it is a problem of social also, or we can say that unemployment also creates a social problem. Now, let's see how unemployment is a political problem. Students, unemployment has political implication. Implication means effect also. People who are not employed always show anguish. The phenomenon of unemployment shakes the confidence of the people. The basic thinking is that all able-bodied person above and below a certain age must work, and the system should allow them to work. The basic idea is that a person who is just a consumer without being a producer will not be a responsible citizen. It is unfortunate while a few people, the age of 15 and many above the age of 60 and not fully fit, are compelled to work, and many people in their prime willing to work are forced to remain idle. The scene is quite agonizing, as there exists employment of children whose rightful place is school and playground, and non-employment of able-bodied person. So, the root cause of most of our problem is to trace the size of our population. Our workforce has been increasing at a faster rate than our population. Rate of employment has been growing at a lesser rate than that of workforce. So, we do have significant achievement to our credit in handling our population problem. We have brought down fertility rate, brought down infant mortality, raised the age of expectation of life at birth to almost double the years. Now, we have the task of filling our people's average lifespan of 62 years with quality food, nutrition, security, opportunity for education and skill development, and full freely chosen and productive employment. This is our notion or our idea about our country. And no doubt the government is present working in fulfilling these needs. It is our moral duty to work with our systems generated by the government and always be positive in our thinking and in our working. Now, students, in the last part of your lesson, there is a story of a village. As it is given, the main motive of this story is to show how people become an asset rather than liability. Or we can say that how people use their skill, use their knowledge in bringing the downfall of unemployment and creation of employment opportunity. As it is given in the story that each family in that very village produced enough to feed its member. Each family members making their own clothes and teaching their own children. Within this family member, one of the families decided to send their sons to an agricultural college. And after getting admission, he became qualified in agro engineering and come back to the village. The students is so creative that he designed an improved type of plow which increase the yield of wheat. Thus, with the manpower, a new job of agro engineer was created and filled in the village. The family in the village sold the surplus in nearby neighboring village and earned good profit, which they shared among themselves. Inspired by this success, all the family members held meeting in the village and they requested the panchayat to open a school in the village. The village members assured that every children of the village go to a school. All the children, after opening the school, all the children of this village started going to school. And after some time, one of the village members or family member trained his daughter in tailoring. She started tailoring and stitches cloth for all the families of the village. For everyone now wanted to buy and wear well-tailored clothes. Thus, another job, that of a tailor, was created. This had another positive effect. As the farmer spent more time in the field, the yield of the farms went up. This was the beginning of prosperity of the villagers. Over time, this village, which formerly had no job opportunity, now had many job opportunities, like that of a teacher, tailor, agro engineer, and many more. Thus, a simple village where the rising level of human capital enabled it to evolve into a place rich with complex and modern economic activities, then why we are not? We can develop our skill, our knowledge, and we also produced in such a way that every people have been utilized properly. This is the end of our lesson. And I'm going to give some homework of 5 questions to you. As you see on the screen, your first question is define density of population. Second one is how will you explain the term unemployment, describe its type also. The third question is how human resource can be developed. Number next, explain whether high population is an asset or a liability. The last question, why is educated unemployment is peculiar problem in India? You solve at your home and share your answer through my WhatsApp number as I have given to you in our previous video. Still, if you don't have or you don't written it, then again note down 8969 403 222 and feel free to show your answer so that I'm able to correct where you have problems. Thank you very much. Next day we will come again with our new lesson of geography. Thank you.